Hi, my name is Pedro and this is On My Function. This is the video number 7 of a series I'm creating to teach you about data visualizations using technologies like React, D3, VisX, and TypeScript. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to create D3 axes, and actually you need to learn how to create scales first. So if you don't know and if you didn't watch my last video, go watch it now. Well, axes and charts are those references that you see on the borders of the chart that give you kind of a reference of what the chart is about. Creating an axis on D3 is really easy because you just need to actually get a scale and pass the scale to the axis function, appending it to a group, because of course you know that you have to separate it. And then you have to customize the ticks that are those reference points on the axis. And it's not that hard to create, but it can get very confusing in some cases. So let's see how I create them. Right, so I'm gonna use the same template as I always use, that is the vanilla one. And then, well, what I'm gonna do is remove that boilerplate that is always there, delete this one, and delete this one. And first things first, I need to install D3, right? Right, so now I can import as D3 from D3. Now I have D3, I need the data points. I'm gonna copy and paste some data points here because it's faster and you don't wanna see me creating them. Now, if you remember well, I need to create the scales, I need to define the width and the height of my chart. So const width is 300 and const height is 250. Cool. Now I need to create the SVG to append the axis. So const SVG equals d3.select the body, and then I'm gonna append an SVG, and then I'm gonna make the attribute of width as width and the attribute of height as height. Right, easy enough. Oh, yeah, I changed the things here, but that's fine. Cool, now I have my SVG. Let's see how I create my scale. On this case, because I want it to be easier for you to see, I'm going to create a scale band that is basically a scale that separates each one of these data points as ticks on the axis. So it separates, like, if I have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 data points, it's going to get me 5 ticks, 5 references on the axis. So what I'm gonna do is create now the scale. So it's gonna be an X axis. So first X is equal to d3.scaleband, and you can read the documentation, but basically the scale band is pretty easy to understand. The domain here is gonna be literally the data, because I have all the data points that I need. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 here. And the range is gonna be from 0 to width. And yeah, I'm gonna add a padding of 0.1 to make it look prettier. So let's create the axis now. Const x axis. I told you it's really easy. I just need to create like a function, and then x axis is actually axis bottom, because I want to create it on the bottom. I need to pass the scale to it. So after that, I need to, well, I actually don't need to do anything, but I can chain function that is tick format to give me the D, that is this object. And I want the tick to be D.name. And I want the tick size outer to be 0. So what's wrong? Oh, okay. I messed up here on the range. Yeah, this needs to be an array. And then, yeah, what I want to do now is basically SVG, append a G group. And then I'm going to call this function. This is the D3 thing because I can't reference itself. I can't make it reference itself on the chart. So I have to append a group to it and use the call function to call the X axis. Then what I have is the, I have the axis here. This is very simple. This is a very simple example, but it gives you a grasp of how to create them. And when we put everything together, it's going to be easier for you to understand. See, it's not that hard to create axes with D3. On the next video, I'm going to create a bar chart. So we're going to use everything that we learned on these videos about creating scales, axes, and we're going to create a useful bar chart that you can use anywhere you want. If you like this video, please subscribe and hit me in the comments if you have any questions. Thumbs up really helps, and I think that's it. See you around. Bye-bye.